Oh, ladies and gentlemen, welcome. Welcome back to the channel. Hope you guys are doing great, staying safe, all that stuff, man. I appreciate y'all so much. And shout out to all the good humans. Link is always in the description. Now, we got the fifth dimension, all right? It says Aquarius. I don't know if that's an equal sign. Let the sun shine in. Another band I never heard of. But thank you guys so much for the requests. Now, this, I'm looking at this thumbnail here. This is an all black band here. So I'm just wondering if it's a song that I heard, didn't know. You know what I mean? Growing up in my house, I ain't never heard my parents mention the fifth dimension. You know what I mean? So hopefully everything goes smoothly with this. As I said in that video, I'm in this green screen. All right. So hopefully everything goes smoothly. So we ain't gonna waste no more time. Let's jump right into it. I seen them outfits. I hope we dancing. Cause we up, baby. We up. Shout out to all the Leos.
When the moon is in the seventh house and Jupiter aligns with Mars, then peace will guide the planets and love.
I was gonna say, where is
that? This is the dawn.
And the 40-year-old virgin is going on here. Wait a minute. Yo. Right? 40-year-old virgin? At the end when it was like all the hippies dancing? Yeah, because the reason I remember, because it was like watching that movie, which was so funny. Then I was like, this is odd. That's what's going on here at the end. After that brother got himself some smack dab. Okay. Fifth dimension.
This is the dawning of the age of Aquarius. Age of Aquarius. Aquarius.
Crazy, because if I close my eyes, they don't look nothing like they sound. This look like, you know, if somebody was like, sent me a picture and was like, can you react to this song? Like, what, as I saw the thumbnail, I thought this was going to be like something that might have, I'm not saying they wasn't on Soul Train or nothing like that, but I thought this would be more upbeat, you know what I mean, just from the title. But it's just tripping me out. Even when I heard it on a 40-year-old version, I didn't know this what the group looked like. This is crazy. Loving the harmonies and how everybody is all color coordinated. Wow. They almost sound like they could probably sing some opera too. Wonder what else they got. I feel like I've been bamboozled. Now this one I know for show. Yo. Okay. This is tripping me out, man. 'Cause like if they would have started with this song, you know what I mean? I would have been like, "Oh, okay." Even though I recognize it from 40-year-old version, but if they would have started with this one seemed like this one fits their style more. The other one, the Aquarius, just tripped me out. I didn't know that was them. Yo. Yo, see, this is what I'm talking about, man. Really love the versatility. That just shows like how great artists are. 'Cause like I said, that first song, like once I recognized it from the movie, I just was shocked. Like I honestly, I thought whoever sang the Aquarius song was white. I'll just say that. All right. Almost shocked me more than finding out the Righteous Brothers was black. It's just when you hear certain music, especially when I saw the thumbnail and then I heard Aquarius and it, that song went in my head, and I just didn't, for me, the look didn't match the voice. That's why I was like, hold on, they sing that? And then when it got to the second song, I'm like, okay, this seems more like something they would sing. You know what I mean? That's crazy, though. It just shows you how versatile they are. Like, I want to see more from them because, let me see here. I'm trying to see what this song did as far as, you know, like on the charts and stuff like that. So, is it a two-part song? Cause I don't remember Let the Sun. I've heard The Sunshine In before, but I don't recall that being in the 40-year-old version. But this song charted at number one. Which one? Or is this this Aquarius and Let the Sunshine In? Is that, even though it's two songs, is it one combined that charted at number one? You know, just listening to that kind of sound like a, when I was like listening to the lyrics and stuff, especially on the second one, just open up your heart and let the sun shine in. Like, come on. To me, that just like almost, if you want to go there, like almost like getting to know others. You know what I mean? Open up your heart to others, to me. I'm just trying to see here if, like, just looking at some song facts. Oh, so they written for the rock opera hair, where it became an anthem for young people who grew their hair out and protested the government. Wow. I mean, even though you couldn't see them, you're hearing that doom, 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 doom. I love that. I just can't stop thinking of the Aquarius. Like, I can't hear that song without thinking of that movie. And I just see all the, you know, that's what I'm thinking of. Shout out to all the Leos again. But, hey, appreciate y'all. I think I'm going to go and listen to some more of them, just to see what else they got, because that was a pleasant surprise, you know. But yeah, hopefully everything went smoothly with this. Like I said, I am in this green screen. If I had to put myself over here and the box there, that mean the green screen didn't work. What I'm trying to do is have me small and show the whole video kind of with me in the corner, really, really small. But if it looks like kind of like normal, that means it didn't work. So, hey, again, appreciate you guys coming over, helping me keep great music alive. See y'all in the next video. Peace out.